gentlemen, looking on the left-hand side, we are passing a gray and white building, and this is the Antigua Barbuda Museum. Originally built in 1750 as a courthouse, and later on established in 1835 as the Antigua Barbuda Museum. But this morning, ladies and gentlemen, do you know that the building was the architectural style of this building is called neoclassical, but it was also built with the yellow freestones coming from the surrounding offshore islands of Antigua. Ladies and gentlemen, we're now traveling on a street that's called Long Street. Anyone knows why this is called Long Street?
Long Street.
Of course. But also, we're crossing over a street that's called Corn Alley. And do you know the Corn Alley was where the corn merchants used to sell their corn? But also, that corn was once income here in the island. But do you know what else was income? Rum, which is also the international language. Now, looking on the left-hand side, do you notice this wall? How it's leaning over, how it's broken apart? Doesn't it resemble the bridge in New Jersey, which Governor Christie said he was going to fix? But if I have any Londoners on board, doesn't it resemble London Bridge falling down? But actually, ladies and gentlemen, I don't know why these circumstances took place. But do you know that our wall is over 300 years old? And was built to encase the first Anglican church, which was built in 1843, damaged by an earthquake, and rebuilt in 1847. But did you also notice the two statues upon the church? They were St. John the Baptist and St. John the Divine. They were captured from a French warship during the Seven-Year War. Looking on the right-hand side, folks, we have the center wall. And that was built for those soldiers who fought in World War I and World War II. Now, although we do not know their stories, we say thank you to them every November 11th, or the Sunday that is close to November 11th, for keeping our island safe. But also, folks, here on the right, we have a golden yellow building. And this is the National Archives of Antigua, built in the 1990s. But two buildings which were first erected there, one was an old Scottish church, and the other was an old play hall known as Princess Elizabeth Hall. But folks, do you know that the island of Antigua has been independent since November 1st, 1981? But that we're also governed by a prime minister. So coming up on the right, you're going to see some beige and white buildings. And these will be some of our ministries here on the island. You have the Ministry of Housing and Culture, the Ministry of Finance, the Ministry of Tourism, our Prime Minister's Office, and our Parliament Building, where our heads of government meet once every month to discuss the pressing matters in our country. But have you ever listened to a parliamentary debate before?
Yeah.
Or a Senate debate?
Yeah.
Doesn't it sound like a fish market to you? Now, I do not know the reason why grown men gotta be arguing so much, but ladies, we can definitely show them a thing or two. Because guess what? We have five ladies in the upper house. We have, not to tip off our hats very much here, fellas, but recently announced that the Prime Minister's wife will be running for that office. But on the same ticket now. But also, we hadn't seen another party being arisen from the ashes here in Antigua, which is called the DNA. And do you know who heads that party? A woman. So we will see how far she gets in this election. Now, looking on the left-hand side of here, we have the Johnson Village. And the Johnson's Village was built as the cheapest and best housing facility here on the island for persons coming from lower income families. But that is just one story, everyone. You know, there are always two sides to every story, yours, mine, and sometimes we even forget to tell the truth. So would you like to hear the truth now?
Oh, yeah.
You don't sound all excited here. Would you like to hear the truth now?
Yes!
Yes! All right, that sounds much better. All right, so folks, now, Governor Johnson was a very envious man. He built the Johnsons for trailer to take persons away from the Wellborn Fines Institute. But unfortunately, Governor Fines was smarter than him and said he had some freeloaders placed and wants to get rid of them. Now, unfortunately, folks, you will not be able to use them here. Because to drive in the roads in Antigua, you need a special degree. Anyone knows what that is? No? Well, actually, it's called a PhD, a pothole dodging degree. So if you see the driver swerving from left to right, don't be scared, he's just dodging the potholes. And do you know that our driver's name is Joseph? And Joseph got his license yesterday. But got his PhD today. So God help us all. Here on the right-hand side, folks, we have a village known as Potters. Now, Potters, we do not know how it originally got its name. Some persons believe it's for the rich clay soil was in that village, going to and from the Caribbean Islands, called the Caribbean Airlines, or just simply Caribbean Airlines. So, folks, if you want to come to Antigua for 1 week, 1 year, 1 month, we are able to accommodate you. Because guess what? We have self-checking services, escalators, elevators, and 5 jet ramps. Because when you would have come to Antigua, you would have felt the snow, which is actually the clear kind, not the white kind of back home. All right, so folks, here on the right-hand side, we have the posters of our 6 national heroes. Now, folks, first up, we have V.C. Byrd. We also have Lester Bryant Byrd. There's also George H. Walter, Nellie Robinson, King Court, and also Vivian Richards. Now, just to tell you a little bit more about our national heroes this morning. V.C. Byrd, father of the nation, because he went to Britain requesting for our independence. Because they asked him, how could you pay for this independence? He said, by ear and by sea. So now everyone knows your main source of income, which is tourism. Our second national hero, George H. Walter, he was our second premier here on the island, while Sevier was our first and third, but made the island famous for its black pineapple. Have you ever heard of a black pineapple before, folks? Well, maybe if we're lucky this morning, and also if you're good boys and girls, we might be able to see this black pineapple, and maybe even get a taste of it as well, too. For our third national hero, which was a woman, because you kind of have an island without running things, right, fellas? Right, boys?
Yes.
Now, ladies, there are only 2 answers. Yes, dear, and yes, dear. Now, her name was Mrs. Nellie Robinson. And Mrs. Robinson, she built a school for children coming from non-white families. Because in those days, persons believed that once your parents were not married, you did not deserve to go to school. So she said every child needed an education and built the school named after her husband, which is Thomas O'Reilly Robinson Memorial School, T-O-R for short. And do you know that that school is still existing in this day, folks? Open to each and every child from each and every different background. For our fourth national hero, whose name was King Court or Prince Glass. He was a house slave and never had to endure the hardships of a field hand. But one day after his master sent to the marketplace, he befriended the field hands and learned about their hardships. Then decided he was going to overthrow the government with 33 other house slaves. But unfortunately, after a night of rum drinking and card playing with the soldiers, King Court was captured, stretched on a wheel for half an hour in the sun, then later on beheaded, where his head was chopped off and placed on top of a pole. Everyone could see it. Looking on the left to the side this morning, folks, we have the remains of what was once our sugar factory.
Oh my goodness.
Originally built in 1904-1905. Then finally closed its doors in 1971 because of cheaper rates of producing sugar in England and cheaper ways of exporting it in the Americas. But folks, did you see how the factories all rusted over? we say, let that factory rust in peace. Looking on the right hand side here, we have some towers, but also, do you notice the houses? Those were formerly a part of an estate known as North Sound Estate, where in 1820 George Thomas family, and it was once 660 acres and home to 295 slaves. A slave by the name of Papasami, who once lived on the estate, mentioned in a book called Shuha Labor. His responsibilities as a child slave, which was to place dung at the first machoke. He also mentioned about the first murder that they saw, which was a murder of a slave known as Patty Bab. Usually in the mornings they had roll call, and one morning Patty did not answer. So the master took it as a sign of disrespect, placed her in the cellar of the estate house, but when they went to release her, she was already dead. She was also hauled by rats. I know, folks, that was just an awful way to die. But that was just some of the hardships which we had to go through as slaves here in Antigua. Now, for most of you here on the bus, do you know about the game of cricket?
Yes.
And I'm sure we have some Brits on board this morning. Now, for those of you Americans who are not too familiar with the game of cricket, now, it is played similar to baseball, where the ball bounces on the pitch to the batter, and the batter sees how far he can hit it. If he hits it to the white line, it is 4 runs. If he hits it way off the white line, it is 6 runs. All right, so folks, now, the Vivian Richards Cricket Stadium, folks, was built for the 2007 World Cup Series. And could anyone guess who won that World Cup Series? The West Indies did. But also, folks, we met up with the 2020 matches, and guess who won that as well, too? The West Indies did. But actually, folks, we had it took a turn for the worst there, which we went up for the one-day matches, and we started. But do you know, with having so many beaches and such a high population, not even half of us can swim? And it is sad to say that I'm in both brackets, the sewers and non-sewers. But I can do dog paddle, I can do back float, I can do butterfly. But to save someone's life, that's not me. So I'm hoping to take classes at the stadium. Maybe sooner or later, I'll become like the great American swimmer, Michael Phelps. Do you think you can do it, folks?
Yeah.
All right, awesome. Now, folks, since you have so much faith in me, check me back in 10 years. By then, I'll be ready for Michael. But by the end, you can watch me on the television. So folks, coming up on the right hand side, you're going to see a white wall, and that will be encasing the Luna Park. Now, the Luna Park, folks, when it was ordered by Mr. John I. Martin, they had some loud dances every night, which were called rounds. And one particular night, folks, the music was so loud that all the crystal chandeliers dropped and broke. Believe once you carried a coin to that tree, tacked it in, or threw it at the base of the tree, it's going to be relieved. But if in case that we had any person with sticky fingers, if they tried to take the coin away from that tree, they would automatically get the pain from that coin. There is no taking any coins away from the pain tree. But also on the bite, we have some white cattle. Are known as the Brahmins. And the Brahmins are very important to a particular type of culture. Yes, the Indians, also known as the Hindus. Because the Hindus, they worship them. morning I'm going to do. They feed them, worship them, watch them grow, then watch them die. But here in Antigua, we feed them, watch them grow, and then we eat them. So please don't tell the Hindus that we have them here, because they might want to come and take them away from us. That's all the secret, right? But did I also mention to you that the other Caribbean islands do not like it? They call us garrets. They say we talk too much. So please don't tell me any secrets, because I will not be able to keep it. For our sixth and final living national hero, folks, his name was Lester. As a youth, he played sports here for the island of Antigua, such as cricket, soccer, and also tennis. Then later on, going to England to study to become a lawyer. Afterwards, he came back here to the island and did law practice, but eventually gained access to the political movement with his father, B.C. Burr Sr. He later on became one of the longest-ruling prime ministers here on the island, where that party was in power for 28 years, but he was only prime minister for 15 years. So that was a great accomplishment. Today, folks, he is still in the political game, but he's no longer prime minister here in Antigua. He's actually now the minister of commerce. Looking on the right and left hand side this morning, you may be able to see some fields that have been cleared off, on corn, sweet potatoes, kumquats, cassavas, yams, and this process is known as agriculture. Agriculture only accounts for 10% of our income here on the island, whereas 20% is finance and 70% the most being tourism. Why so little for agriculture, you may ask? Because we only get about 45 inches of rainfall every year. And sometimes in a very severe drought period, we do not even get up to the 36-inch mark. Here on the right-hand side, darlings, we're just passing a village known as Freeman's Village. Freeman's Village was named after its once owner, Mr. Willis Freeman. But after we became emancipated from slavery in 1834, we freed three villages at the same time, which of course were Freetown, Freeman's Village, and Liberta. And in case you'd like to remember the names, there are two Frees and one Liberty. Today, ladies and gentlemen, we do not plant sugarcane for cash purposes anymore. But once you have a large enough backyard, or the front part of your property is large enough, you can plant a piece of sugarcane. And how you would eat it is that if you cut out the hard exterior, leaving a white or greenish inside, you will try to bite and suck at the same time. But don't worry if you have a bit of juice running down your chin. That just means that you're an expert sugarcane eater. Gentlemen, are you noticing that we have palm trees all around us? We only have two types of palms that are originally brought from Africa. We have the date palms and also the coconut palms. Now, the date palms are brought here to feed the camels. Yes, folks, we did have camels once roaming here on the island, but they all died of hoof disease. They were brought here by a gentleman called Alec, so we dubbed him Smart Alec. Because he did not realize that Antigua was wet and dry, and not a dry climate alone. So once rains came and the water got up into the hoofs of the camels, they all died. So we had to resort back to using the donkeys. But with the coconut palms, folks, they have many different uses. Because the palms can be used as brooms to sweep your homes, while the nuts are the largest out of all the nuts. And when we crack it open, you can drink the water out of it, which is used to flush your kidneys. But most men in Antigua like to drink it with alcohol. They taste better that way. Am I right, boys? can see on the smiles on the faces, ladies, so I know it must be true. But also, when you crack the nuts wide open, you can eat the white meat out of it, which is not too sweet, not too sour, just right. But after the meat is more, you can grate it. To make sweets, sugar cake and also coconut tarts. But when the meat ages more and still hard enough to grate, you can grate it to extract the oils out of it, which is used to anoint your joints when you have aches and pains, and to grease your hair to make it shiny, soft, and nice. But another great use for this coconut oil, folks, it is a great way for growing hair. So if you know anyone with any bald spots, you can simply tell them to use a coconut oil, because a little bit goes a long way. So you won't even have to bother with the store-bought stuff called Rogaine. Now I know that Rogaine is out of style right now. I just recently saw a video yesterday, which is another great way for growing hair. Sort of like a spray. No rumor is called hair folks. So do apologize for that. But also, do you know that coconut oil is a great cure for Alzheimer's? A teaspoon of that every day will definitely slow down the process of Alzheimer's. In the largest village here on the island, that is the village of All Saints. It is the largest village because it has four parishes meeting here. Although Antigua has six, only four of them are here in All Saints. Because we've just come from St. John's, we passed St. Peter's and St. Mary's, and we will be going to St. Paul's